What is up, everybody? Welcome back to the Binding of Isaac Afterbirth. Random hard streaks. We're on a 3-win streak, man. All right? That's not bad, you know? You gotta start somewhere. Rome was not built in a day, popular to contrary belief that it was built in a day. It wasn't built in a day. Look at our damage stat and our tier rate and our mohawk. This is all good. This is all good things. And we can slow down the room by using the spider sack. This is good, man. This is like as good of an Eden start as you probably can get, other than, you know, an Eden start with Godhead. But like, that just doesn't happen, you know? This is not gonna happen. You're not gonna start with Godhead as Eden. It's impossible. The odds are so bad that it's actually impossible. I'm obviously kidding, considering we did the other day we started with Godhead, which was awesome. But honestly, our damage right now and our tier rate, our shot speed is a little low, but it's not going to matter, like, at all. It's not going to matter at all, considering our damage is so good. And we also have milk, is it called? Oh yeah, I forgot to put the item tracker on. Probably should pause the game while I do that. That would be in my best interest. Let's see here. Item tracker. Sorry, guys. It's just sometimes you forget to start it up with the item tracker on there, but there it is. Again, people are commenting to telling me to do Missing HUD 2. I don't like Missing HUD 2. It takes away the magic of Isaac for me for some reason. I just don't like the numbers being like shown in my face with the damage stat in regards to like damage stat and speed and all that. I'd like to feel them out naturally. I know some viewers like to see the numbers and all that, but it just, it kind of takes a little bit away from the core Isaac game for me. I get that it's a useful tool, but I feel like I say this like once every 4 episodes because I just keep getting comments saying use Missing HUD 2. But I guess there's a new audience, which that's a good thing, you know? If I have to keep answering that question, it's good, man. That means more eyes are getting on the video, newer eyes that haven't heard me say the Missing HUD rant. But there it is. So we keep it simple. We keep it simple here with that tracker down there. Obviously, a bomb would be huge right now. Hugely important. I only have 2 cents. And there's 2 tinted rocks. And then there's also a soul heart just sitting down there for the taken. But we can't take it because we don't have a bomb. Whoa, that was weird. He was slowed. And his jump got like halted mid-air there. I tried to run under him. We actually didn't get hit, which is good. This monstro fight is going by pretty quickly. He is jumping often. We got Kane's Other Eye. I mean, there's not much to be said about Kane's Other Eye than it's an item that exists in the Isaac universe, and it bounces around the room, sometimes shooting tears. So there it is. Pentagram's a great start. It's going to add to our already good damage, and we're going to leave this floor. Just kidding. You thought I was going to leave with all these hematemesis red hearts on the floor, but I'm not. I'm going to go into the curse room, hope for some chests that, you know, contain guppy items or bombs. There's actually 3 tinted rocks. Okay, so we just got 2 soul hearts out of it, which I think, well, I know, was worth the trip down here. The problem is there was no bomb, so we're just going to have to look at a room like this and just kind of leave and then pass 3 tinted rocks on the way. I mean, there could be worse things that we're missing out on, but it's not great. I think we're in an amazing position, though. Like, our damage stat right now, especially now with the pentagram, it's really, really good for Cellar 2. Another tinted rock. The tinted rocks are coming fast and furious. Like, Vin Michael Diesel. That's his middle name. Vin Michael Diesel. They're coming fast and furious, man. There's no bombs to access them. Look at Kane's Other Eye, though. He's trying to shut me up. He's like, you think I just exist? He's trying to show me that he thrives in this universe. I don't believe him yet, but maybe somewhere down the line we will see him thrive. Another tinted rock. Surprise, surprise. And bombs? 2 bombs. Just what the doctor ordered. I don't think I could stretch this to try to get the secret room. I don't know. All right, so we used the key. Pretty gutsy there to use a key, considering we didn't have, you know, a backup plan other than hoping for another key. I'm not going to take Bob's brain. Pretty sad that it shows up in an item room just because, you know, that's usually a golden chest item that shows up. But I guess it's in the item room pool as well, so... I almost hit that button. I almost went out that door. I wonder what would have happened. Bombs shouldn't be a problem now, though. Oh, God. What is happening with these? They're all, like, off. I can go back for that tinted rock, but... I'm going to try to get in here. I know that won't do it, but hopefully we get a bomb from that. We don't, but this is still a tinted rock, you know? Let's check it out. We got more bombs and a coin that didn't drop a bomb. I kind of thought it would. We also have a key and 17 cents. Before we go back to the shop and the tinted rock and golden, not golden chest, but angelic chest. I don't know what you call it. Whatever you want to call it. Let's slow him down here. It feels like a good time to do so. He's just gonna... Oh, jeez, really? But yeah, we get a damage up if we get hit in the room because of spilled milk, I believe. I believe that's how this item works. I think he just spawns spiders. I don't have to really worry about much else. We held on to one soul heart, which is good enough to get ourselves a deal with the devil. Dude, it's unbelievable. This has to be some sort of record. Like, no joke... Recorded evidence of this is crucial, because if there was no recorded evidence of this, no one would believe me that I said, if I were to say, hey guys, I did 6 Isaac episodes in a row and every single time Dark Bum showed up. No one would believe me, dude. And now it's documented on the internet forever. I know it wasn't 6 in a row. That might have been a slight exaggeration, but honestly, I would say... 5 out of the last 10 episodes, he showed his face. I that might be completely off, but that's my educated guess. I would say 5 out of the last 10. So half of the episodes, you know, of the last 10, he showed his face, which is so rare. I feel like I never see Dark Bum at times, and all of a sudden... Oh, we're seeing him every episode, and it sucks, man. I want deal with the devil precedent, but I don't want Dark Bum following me around. Like, it's you can't have your cake and eat it too, you know. So, maybe we're gonna get some angel deals on this run, which I'm okay with. I'm okay with that. I have no problem with angel deals. I feel like I've been running into some angel deals recently, and they've been good to me, man. They've been good to me. Some of the times. I feel like the last couple runs, I complained a lot about the lackluster items they were giving me. That's besides the point. I don't know. I'm trying to make up for me not taking that deal with the devil. So, yeah, just bear with me. Bear with me. Although Holy Shot was like the MVP... If not for Soy Milk being the MVP. But, I mean, the culmination of both of them was the reason why that run was so good. Holy Shot was a huge contributor to that run. And Holy Shot has gotten an angel room. So, there you go. Okay, one more Fat Bat. He is dead. Those are really tanky characters. So, I'm not going to fret that it took maybe a little bit longer to kill them than you would imagine with this kind of damage. That's just how it is. Let's take that. A couple batteries laying around. We'll use it right off the bat here. Oh, Kane's other eye got that snipe. He got that snipe. I'm on the lookout for him, man. I'm checking him out, man. I'm giving him a little item revision. You know, every once in a while, you got to do an item revision. I've had, you know, a opinion about Kane's other eye for as long as I can remember. And sometimes you got to give it the revision it deserves. So that's what we're doing right now. I have my other eye on Kane. Watching him at all times, seeing if he thrives in the Isaac universe, you know? You just got to pay attention to these things. We do want a key. That's not a key. That's Lazy Worm. We had Lazy Worm a couple runs ago, so we're going to avoid taking Lazy Worm. It's not necessarily good, but at the time, I thought it was interesting. I thought it was interesting at the time. Maybe not. Maybe not. All right, we do have bombs, and we're gonna use the bombs to get to the keys. The pill interested me more than the scent. Either way, we're gonna get the scent. Oh, the luck up's so good. The luck up's so good. We do have 20 cents, so you know what? Another bomb bringing us down to 5 bombs and getting us to 2 keys, giving us a chance to get into the item and the shop room, I think is gonna be worth it in the long run. We're still at 5 bombs, and we're gonna get so many more bombs because of our trinket. Every time we pick up a penny, we have a chance to drop a bomb, so... I feel like I've seen this item recently. What? These item rooms have been bad. To say the least, they've been just bad. All right, we'll do this. Buy this. No nickel, but we're gonna get some money from the sack. And there's our bomb that I was talking about before. That luck up probably helped this trinket out a lot. Gonna donate as much as possible. We're up to 122. I did go under the 5 cent threshold, so I probably won't get an arcade on the next floor. Not too big of a deal. It feels like the secret room is here. Let's just go into this room and then look to the left. Yeah, it very well could be here. So let's check it out. It's not there. Okay. It could be on the bottom here. All right, well, it's not. I mean, it could be on the bottom right. It could also be on the right side of the map. There's a lot of places it can be. So maybe it wasn't even the best time to check for one, but I just know that we're gonna be, you know, bomb plentiful because of the trinket. So I didn't really mind spending some bombs looking for the secret room. Secret room isn't always like the highest of my priorities. I know a lot of people kind of get triggered if I don't look for the secret room. A lot of people are like, oh, dude, Jay, you had 4 bombs and you didn't look for a secret room. And it's like, I don't know. Sometimes it's not worth the 4 bombs or even 1 bomb to me anyway. We might have lost our deal with the devil there. I don't think we would have got one because we didn't take the last one, but I can just shut up now because we're just going to be fighting, or we're just going to be in the angel room, and it's rosary, and I'll take it. It's going to give us a lot of health, but it's also going to make the Bible show up. All right, we're fighting the red angel. He's definitely the harder of the two, for sure. That being said, though... Wow, our speed is really bad, huh? I did not realize our speed was so bad. I feel like he shoots the beams less. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, because that means he shoots the red tiers more. There's the beams. We did get a health up, too. He is, like, at half health now. It's taken a long time. Get him, Kane's other eye. Get him, baby. Get him, baby! Okay. All right. Sometimes you could bait him into this weird, like, back and forth type, like, aggro where, you know, you can kind of just get shots off as he tries to track you down to start a beam shot. It's a little weird of a mechanic, but... Okay, just because we're getting these key pieces, you know what? I am going to take the chance at a blue fire here. Top right always feels right. And we are right. That was just pure luck. We could continue to explore a little bit. I mean, I would like a key to access that chest. I don't know if we're going to be able to get in the boss trap room, but there isn't actually an extra room down here that we could check out. I was going to say, some of the consumables might have turned into sacks. And that's kind of just what happened. I'm holding on to a chariot just in case we get like a demon beggar or a blood donation machine or something. This dude's pitch right now. The bomb of destiny there. And it was worth it, man. It was worth it. Especially checking out in here. It's not super worth even checking this out because it's only 1 stone chest. But it's not like a big deal. It's really just a time sink. I don't think it's going to kill us because we checked the stone chest in here. But I don't really know what my health is at. We've been on this floor for what seems like a while. And we've had a Curse of the Unknown the whole time, so I'm a little lost at what our health is going to be at. Especially because we got a health up and picked up a soul heart. We could just take that. We could just take it. We don't have to run all the way back. That's pretty convenient. Okay, so our health is way better off than I thought, and I didn't even think it was going to be that bad, but it's way better off than I thought. It's in a very good position. Oh, yeah, now it's hitting me. I got Rosary on the deal with the angel. It all makes sense now. That totally makes sense that we have this much health. I should have realized that, but I didn't. Also, probably thinking back on it, I probably shouldn't have used a bomb on the blue fire just because of the sheer, you know, bad chance there is to get a soul heart out of it anyway. But it ended up working out, one, and we really have to remember the bombs are not going to be a problem. The trinket is here. I haven't dropped the trinket for something. Two of spades, double the keys. Might as well do it now. I mean, this isn't the best place to use chariot, but I'll use chariot and take the tower out, and then I don't get hurt leaving the curse room. And you might say, why didn't you just take two of spades and hold on to that instead of the tower? And you'd probably be right. I just didn't think of that maneuver until after I did it. So we're sitting here with the tower, but that means we could swap out this card pretty easily. It's not going to take much to sway me to drop the tower card. Maybe use this, try to get kills before they pop their head back down? We got a decent amount. Seems like a worthwhile play. Didn't think our range was that good, but prove me wrong. Eight keys, head into the item room. Monster manual. I mean, I guess I should pick it up. We'll continue to put money in here, and I'll take Common Cold. I mean, it's not the best item in the game, but poison damage is poison damage, man, no matter how you look at it. No matter how you look at it. Shop is, like, useless for us. Why'd I come in here? Just because of the, you know, this room. It just, you want to go up, just because that's how you usually clear those rooms. But there is a passage over here on the right, so it's good we went in this room. This is probably the way to the boss, if I had to guess. If I was a betting man, I think it's 20 to 1 odds. That would be terrible odds. I don't know who would bet on that. All right, let's pop this right away. Get up in the Stain's face. Use the tower when he does this move. That actually worked out pretty well. Good job, tower card. Maybe get another deal with the angel here, if we're lucky. If we're lucky, we didn't. We got a range up, which doesn't excite me. And honestly, there's not much else going on this floor, especially because we already checked out the curse room. I'm trying to think what would be worth going back to explore for. I mean, maybe some golden chests. That's really it. I mean, we can't fight the boss trap room. Maybe we should just do this for consumables. If nothing else, get some more money. It's freaking Larry Jr. over here. It was super big. All right, okay. Maybe it was worth it. I mean, we're going to get our second key piece here, which hopefully is going to help our chances at another angel deal on the next freaking floor. Excuse me? That doesn't faze him, I guess. Did I time it at, like, the worst possible time when he was doing that animation? I think I did. I think as he was spawning those tears, I did the spacebar item, and it kind of was, like, invulnerable to it, weirdly enough. Okay, there's our second key piece. We get a sack out of it and a temperance card, which is all right. I mean, there's a heart here. Just pop it. A blood bag payout here would be great. Not banking on it, but it would be great. I tried to get it out of the way. It just didn't happen. I really wanted to play this more because I know there was red hearts on the floor, and there's a two of hearts card and a lover's card. We probably would have been able to play that. But we did get a Perthrow rune out of it, which is cool. Two of hearts. So, yeah. We'll roll with the Perthrow. I guess it was worth it. I mean, so far it's been worth it to explore. I always think it is worth it, but sometimes you gotta be convinced, and I'm convinced we got some good stuff out of those two rooms, so let's keep on keeping on, especially with Sackboy. Seems like there's a payout every other room with some sort of consumable. Honestly, that range up has made our range pretty substantial. Okay, I hope I left that two of hearts back there. I don't know if I did. Okay, we have a purr throw, two of spades, which we'll do that right now. I hope I left the two of hearts back here, or the lover's card. I think it's the lover's card. All right, well, I should have brought the lover's card with me. I don't know why I popped it there. That was kind of silly. Play him a couple more times. Getting him to pay out would be awesome right now. Okay. Retrovision. We'll go back for this heart. There's also a heart in the big room. So if this will bring us to a heart and a half, and let's see what's over here, if it's a half heart or a full heart, if we can get it. We can get it. It's only a half heart. Huh? That's a whole extra play out of the Demon Judgment, and this may, yeah, this is definitely putting a nail in the boss rush coffin here, for sure. I mean, we're already at 18 minutes, which is crazy, but we've been doing our due diligence, man. Hopefully it pays out. I know we're hurting soul hearts now, but I'm getting a little bit aggressive here, and I should have known he was going to drop that, but the fact that we touched it, I don't think we're going to see it again. Which is probably the best thing about that. I'm going to purr throw it straight up, and we get a Butterbean, which is terrible. I don't know what item pool that pulled that out of, but it was not the Demon Beggar one, I don't think. I have been taught that the Demon Beggar can pay out with some pretty lame stuff. It did give me Mom's bag of pills, so maybe it has some of that in it. The Butterbean feels like a normal beggar payout. I don't know if they share the same pool. I always thought the Demon Beggar pool was, you know, I know they have different items in it because the normal beggar doesn't pay out with like robes or the mark or the pact or anything. So I know they have differences in their item pools. I just don't know if since I re-rolled that one, it was just like, oh, beggar pools, whether it's demon or normal. I don't know, man. I don't know. I think it was a worthwhile per throw play. It didn't seem like it in the end, but the fact is, the matter is, we could have gotten, you know, a pretty decent item out of that reroll. Almost like a deal with the devil pedestal, which that's what it felt like after I saw what he paid out as, but didn't end up working out. But hindsight's 20/20, and we'll move on without the purr throw rune. It's not the end of the run, not the end of the world. We're still in a very good position. The common cold, the damage ups, the whole thing is catching up to us a little bit just because of the really bad item rooms we've had so far. And the deals with the angels have just not been great. Hopefully we get one here, though. We did get one on the last floor, but it was courtesy of a red chest. Speak of the devil, there's a red chest right there, which is paid out with spiders. Not going to do much for me. I have no idea how I didn't get hit there. That boggles my mind. Like, actually boggles my mind. Did Kane's other eye take out those spiders? If so, thank you, bud. I think he did. I think he did it all on his own. All on his own. Yeah, I was getting a little bit cornered in there. Okay, death card, hermit. Was that death card on the ground the whole time and I never picked it up? Could have picked it up and killed off that last wave easily. We'll hit this. Sack, penny, some more bombs, courtesy of our trinket. A big room. Oh, really? Really now? That hit me. I'm not gonna deal with it. We're gonna check out the curse room. Not thrilled about this kind of curse room. Rather have seen some red chests. Maybe a teleport into the deal with the angel. Maybe a guppy item. Instead, we get the devil, which is actually a pretty good card. Hit this, get some more sacks, consumables for days. Judgment. That is the normal judgment, which I will play because he could give me a health up or mapping, and I'll take either of those right now. Maybe should have checked out our shop first, but if we do see something we really want, we could bomb our donation machine a little bit. This run is still very much in question, man. Like, it's one of those things where it was such a good start damage-wise, we just haven't gotten anything really to follow it up. The devil, two of hearts. Well, we'll pop two of hearts right now. Fill up the red heart containers. But yeah, it's still in question, man. Which is, I mean, you know, that's fine with me. I'm cool with not being completely OP by Necro 1, Dank Depths 1, whatever it may be. I'm okay with that. I'm okay. We can power through. It's a slower run. We're already at 22 minutes. Which I guess all the exploring on the floors kind of catches up with you, time-wise, anyway. Common cold's so good, though. You hit him with a common cold shot, and it's just the damage over time usually gets the best of him. Tower card. You know what? Let's use it here. I mean, it's not. It was worth trying. I will try to do this. Sometimes a little trickier than it seems. Okay. We got some more consumables out of it. We're kind of rolling deep in the consumables right now. I don't know if we'll need all them yet at this point, especially with the rate we're getting them. I don't think we'll ever be able to catch up. I don't know, again, how I dodged there, but I did utilize that half-broken poop to try to get around, and it ended up working out. I would credit that, chalk that one up to being lucky. Okay, so if we fight Gish, we're not going to get Little Gish. Brightest part about getting Little Gish is that you won't see him if you get Gish. Okay, I think I'm going to blank card. I think I'm going to blank card here. Rip Donation Machine, we just kind of started to feed back into it, so it's a little sad to, you know, start hurting it again, but gotta do what you gotta do. I was going to say this is probably going to be a two of diamonds. Whoops. All right, well, we get two of diamonds now, and then we can buy the blank card. Let's see what kind of cards we got here. Tower, blank card devil, blank card world interests me, and blank card death. Honestly, world is so good. Like, we're going to have mapping the rest of the run, barring any curses of the lost, I guess. The best play here would have been taking the curse, or sorry, the devil. That would be the best card to take here. Blank card devil is like basically a Judas's, or a Book of Belial. Basically. A poor man's Book of Belial, but a Book of Belial nonetheless. But I love mapping, and I think it's going to speed us up a little bit. Which, not like we need to be sped up, but we can also access these secret rooms? On all the floors, basically. A luck up. Infested. I'm okay with taking question mark pills just because if we get a luck down, we've already had two luck ups. So we would still be, you know, ahead of the curve on the luck sense. So I don't mind taking mystery pills. Plus, it adds a little, like, you know, you never know. You never know what you're gonna get. And the Fallen's going to get us to deal with the Devil item, and it ended up being Death's Touch, which is so good. And then we get Flight here, which I was going to fight him. I don't know what is with me, and I'm always trying to fight him. And we get the Seraphim transformation, which I rarely get, but I guess when you get Angel deals right off the bat, that's going to happen. But getting Flight is huge. Blank card world, of course we get Curse of the Lost. Why wouldn't we get Curse of the Lost? Why freaking wouldn't we? All right, we'll play the bank a little bit. We got Blood Bag, which is a slight HP up, which is exactly what the doctor ordered, along with Flight. Blank card world, blank card High Priestess. Still gonna go blank card world, even though it's not gonna help us on this floor at all. But the Death Touch pickup is huge. Our tier rate, as you can see, is a little bit low, but we still got that common cold effect going. We still got the damage ups that we kind of started with. That's gonna hurt me. Oh god, I don't know how, but we didn't get hurt. Golden key's good. Blank card hangman is completely useless with flight. We'll keep moving on here. Seraphim transformation is, I just seem to never get it. So it's cool that we got it. Honestly, we're good on bombs, so I'll take Pulse Worm. It makes our hitboxes bigger on the tiers, which, having Death's Touch, our hitbox is already big. So it can only help. It can only freaking help. Where's this other ghost? Hello? Thought you left, bud. Thought you gave up. Thought you locked me in the room. Okay, we will be checking out this curse room, although we don't have any guppy items. Again, I would love a teleport to the angel room. Hey, thank you for dry baby there. Thank you for dry baby there. Just a couple spiders, nothing doing. I would love like a blank card per throw to get a, you know, the cheap man's D6 or something. Unfortunately, we did use the per throw. I mean, that would be considerably weird if I kind of hung on to it for the fact of that we might get blank cards. So that's just unrealistic. But I don't think it was short-sighted. Again, I stand by that per throw play. Not like it's all that big of a deal in the end. It's just, you know, debating for the sake of debating at this point. Okay. We already got our item room, correct? Or no? Am I incorrect? I think I'm incorrect. I kind of forget what it was if we did. I'm just enamored about the Death's Touch and the flight pickups that if I got something after... I know I got Dry Baby, but that wasn't in an item room. That was out of a skull, courtesy of the skeleton hand, which I do appreciate. See if we can get both fires. We actually did get both fires. That has to be like perfectly placed in the middle to get both of them. I'm usually off on that by like a centimeter. That's all it takes. Look at Abel over there putting in work. Again, still not sure if we got the item room. We didn't. Confirmed. I didn't think we did. Red fire dropping soul hearts. All right. It's like that, I guess. It's like that. We also have our shop, which is completely free to go in. Humbling bundle. We don't need to buy a soul heart. Let's put as much money in as we can. Humbling bundle's great. It's going to double all the money and consumables. Do we need it at this juncture? No, probably not. Probably not. Daddy Longlegs is an amazing item, and that probably just solidified our victory if Death's Touch didn't. That definitely did. Daddy Longlegs is one of the best, maybe most underrated item. I don't think it's underrated, but I just think people underrate it slightly. I think it's so good. It's so powerful. Whoo, that was close. I get a little confused about the shadows because we have a Daddy Longlegs shadow. And then a bigger shadow is just the mom's foot. But the mom's foot shadow starts out small. So that's where the confusion lies. So we'll take the Polaroid. Hopefully get Small Rock. We didn't get Small Rock, but a free chest. Ton of consumables. Even more consumables. More consumables. Blank card Joker is what I'm talking about. Okay. We're just going to take the relic. I guess. I mean, it's not like we really need soul hearts, but... And we'll blank card Joker right away. There's no point in really waiting, I don't think. I don't think there's any point in waiting anyway. We're going to get the mind, which completely makes up for dropping blank card world, oddly enough. And, of course, Curse of the Lost again, because, you know, we have some sort of mapping working for us. So it's going to be Curse of the Lost. Curse of the Lost. Good. Good English. It's going to be Curse of the Lost every floor. That's just how it happens when you get some sort of mapping. We needed a black candle is what we needed. But I believe this is going to give us two more deals with the devil. I'm pretty sure you can get a deal with, well, you know what I mean. A deal, let's just say. Whether it's a deal with the angel or a deal with the devil. I guess is yet to be determined. Most likely going to be a deal with the angel. Might as well use the Empress while we can. We're going to get it for free on this room. And then we can use it on the next room, but actually use it. Okay. Walked right into that. I can fly, but not over that guy. Alright, let's get the blank card Joker working again. This way feels right. Boss trap room. Straight down could be it. Could be it. We don't have, like, lump of coal or anything, which is kind of strange. You weirdly get used to Lump of Coal. I don't know how that's a thing, considering you don't get it on every run. Maybe I've gotten it on the past couple of runs, and my brain is just thinking in Lump of Coal terms, because I'm always like trying to get my distance to the enemy, which I guess is a good habit. It's better than like the bad habit of getting close to an enemy. It raises your chances of getting hit. Blank card Empress. We're still going to roll blank card Joker. I mean, the fact is, like... We're not going to get a deal with the angel and or devil on the cathedral, probably without the Joker. So, might as well hold on to it. It's most likely going to be a deal with the angel. I don't know how we would somehow build deal with the devil precedent and lose deal with the angel precedent, especially because we're taking all the angel deals. So I can't see that happening. It's probably going to be deals with the angel, but we can get some cool deals with the angel items. Like, I would love a godhead. I would love a holy shot. Any of those would be awesome. I usually would say flight in there as well, but the deal with the angel is kind enough to give us flight, so we don't have to worry about that. This guy's never going to pop up his head, sir. Sir, I'm going to need you to just pop up your head for like 1 second here, bud. Okay, well, I kind of have somewhere to be. This is a little awkward. Okay. Pops his head up right as I leave, dude. That's so awkward. That's so awkward. That's like you go to your friend's house and he's like, oh, dude, come in, you know? The door's always open. So the one time you come in and you're like, hey, man, like I'm here, and you're like peeking around doors, and then right as you're about to leave, he pops his head out of the bathroom and you still leave. That's exactly what just happened there. Kind of uncomfortable. We're going to fight little Loki here. Experimental treatment. We already got the deal with the angel on this floor. All right, that upped our tier rate tenfold. I don't know what it did to our damage, but it upped our tier rate. So that's cool and exciting. Finally, we get some mapping. Let's blank card Joker. It is one of the worst angel items. I'm not even going to touch it. But again, like I said, we have mapping now. So this womb floor and hopefully the cathedral will go a little bit faster than things have been going. Also, we can cut through here with the sneaky little secret room cut through. I don't really need money, so there's no point in bombing him. But since this happened, oh, got permanent polar invincibility. I was gonna say, if I get another blood bag, it would be all worth it. But blank card AWAS. Blank card Joker. Hey, trapdoor though. Let's check it out. It's not a black market. It's just a sack and more money. Let's see what's in the sack. Ooh, Burcano. Not blank card Burcano. Blank card, you know, Yara. Sign me up, man. Sign me the frick up. I'm a little greedy right now just because blank card Yara sounds like so much fun, so getting these sacks and maybe getting a rune out of it. Something to be said for it, but didn't happen. Didn't happen. If I get more red hearts, I'll come back and play it. But I'm not going to go out of my way for them. I do know there's a red heart to the left of the secret room, which I could check out. I should say. It's just a half, which actually was silly for me to pick up, but it's not going to matter much in the end. Plus, the boss fights are right here. There's another soul heart. Let's just go. I ran right into him, but we get the damage boost from spilt milk. And let's do it. Fire away. We had one normal speed shot. We're getting these weird normal speed slash slow shots going on. A lot of people were mad that I was calling that item Lemon Peel. And I had like a very, you know, big inkling that it wasn't called Lemon Peel, but I still called it that just because I thought it was funny. But people were like, dude, it's called Lemon Mishap, man. Come on, man. You're triggering me. Sometimes I just get like an item name in my head and it's like, yeah, it might not be that, but why not call it that? You know, it is a video game after all. Call it that because we can. All right, blank card Hagalaz doesn't do anything for me. Let's blank card Joker. And we do get a deal with the devil, which is quite funny. We will take this and this. And honestly, there's no point to take this, but we'll take it anyway. I don't know. It actually did nothing. I thought maybe it would change our character cosmetically. And maybe we would lose these huge, ugly Holy Grail wings, but we're not going to lose them. They're with us forever. Like I said, that was completely useless. There's no point in doing that, but... Well, there is a point, if I'm being real. If we can get rid of both of these hearts, we'll have permanent polar invincibility. That's kind of the only logic there. There's not an absolute zero point to it, but very, very close, especially the fact that we're not going to be able to give away our red hearts very easily. Mm-hmm. All right. Secret room. We might as well check it out. It's also gives us into the curse room for free. Blank card alges. Although a very good combination, doesn't seem to be very useful for us. And yeah, here's where the red hearts could have came in the clutch a little bit, but that would be weird foresight to think about that as well. It's not going to be that big of a deal. We don't really need them. We don't really need them. We just need to get to the end, really. This is, I mean, we've been in cruise control for a while now. I think. I don't you know. I don't think there's been much drama even from the start. I mean, the Eden start was so good. The damage was good and the tier rate was good. We only had two hearts, but it's nothing to be alarmed about. I mean, I think one heart is something to be alarmed about, but other than that, I think you're fine, usually. Most of the time, anyway. Okay, killed the Gertie Jr. Hit that. I was gonna say, I haven't gotten many bad pills, and that's not a bad pill, it's a neutral pill. I mean, it's bad for us right now, probably. Our bombs are just kind of bombs as default as you can get them. Wow. Why did that guy drop so much money? Because Daddy Longlegs killed him? Blank card Sun, blank card Moon, blank card Chariot, blank card Judgment.
Judgment.
Well, I guess we could play him. I guess we could play him. Maybe if we get a health up, then we could play the Demon Judgment. We don't really need mapping, though. This is kind of a waste of our time, to be real. Oh, but he did drop a rune. Oh, okay, hold on. What is that? I don't even know what that was. Okay, blank card, I mean, blank card, blank rune? I don't know what it is. The hell is it? Honestly, it's giving me high hopes that it's Yara, because it's not doing anything. We're not spawning flies or anything. It very well could be Yara. I just don't remember the symbols, like when you pop them. It's not saying it either. I mean, I guess I could blank card those bombs, and if they double... Wait, if I blank carded in there, it would have doubled everything. Okay. It's AWAS. That's why it's not doing anything. All right, I see you. I'm sad I blew up that beggar, because... The chance of blank card Yara is really kind of what I'm going for right now. Infested? Alright. Let's move on. Move on. We're one room away from the Isaac fight. We are getting there. Again, slowly but surely, for some reason, this is a 38-minute run. I'm not exactly sure why, because it hasn't been a week run. And it's not like we went, like, above and beyond and did, like, a forget-me-now or a five rune or... I don't know. We didn't even full explore every room, I don't think. It's kind of strange. Whoa. So many tears. Infamy ate one of those, I know that. We've all of a sudden got a lot of familiars. They came out of nowhere, but we have a ton of them now. So blank card, blank rune. That was a weird sentence to say, but that's completely correct. It did sound weird, but yeah, blank card, blank rune is basically blank card AWAS. Not basically, it is blank card AWAS, which is bad. I guess I could go back and get blank card, but we have the mine, so mapping doesn't matter. I mean, blank card Joker doesn't do anything for us on the chest. So I don't know. I'm just hoping for a Yara drop or something in the chest. Even if it comes late, we could start Yaring one chest and turn it into multiple items. Curse of the Unknown. We'll take Dead Aura, even though it doesn't really do much. Probably hurts us, if anything. Book of Sin. Pop that. I guess we could have blank carded Chariot for the Mega Satan fight. Whoa, our tiers are very weird. With Pulse Worm and Dead Aura, they've gotten bigger and they're slower, but it's like, it feels like it's bouncing in and out more. Okay, blank card Alges is really good, especially for the Mega Satan fight. Our damage is nothing great all of a sudden. It's just not showing up as good as it was, I guess, in past rooms. Once you get to the boss fights, it usually tells you how good your damage actually is, but Daddy Longlegs, no denying him. No denying him. Hoping for some more runes here, like a Yara. No Yara, but blank card Emperor. Luck up. Degas, which will get rid of Curse of the Unknown. And, yeah. I mean, we could just fight Mega Satan. There's no real reason to keep exploring. I mean, the blank card Yara is a dream, and it would be cool. But this blank card Algiz is like, we're going to be able to blank card the Algiz and then Algiz and be kind of through the fight. Not all the way, but almost anyway. I mean, if we get into a sticky situation, which I don't think we're gonna, I think this is going to be a relatively easy fight, even though our damage is not as amazing as the tiers might make it seem like it is. I think that's the issue. I think the tiers look like it's very high damage, and it's not low damage by any stretch of the imagination, but I think the tier size just puts on, you know, a bigger face. It has a bigger bark than a bite, let's just say. Oh, that one came for me, and I just looked at it. Couldn't get war out of the first state, so he's going to be dropping bombs on top of the slowness effect here. Again, same thing. Come on, DLL. Get him, dog. Get him, DLL. Kind of saw that coming and just looked at it. Terrible play. Envy should die quick. Again, we have penetrative tears, as you can see, basically exploded. We do have flight, so the creep isn't too big of a deal. But we will be popping the first Algiz here, and I did it a second late. That's terrible. That is terrible. It shouldn't matter. Algiz lasts a long time. This is definitely the hardest phase of the fight, and the angel fight is a little difficult. It's not terrible, though. But again, we're going to be able to normal Algiz after this. Should be dropping bombs. We do have 48 of them. Okay, we're out of it. let's relax here a little bit here. I mean, we are at 3 hits and then we're dead forever with like no respawns, like actually no respawns, but we're holding on to this other rune. I am playing a little stupid just because I knew we had so much invincibility coming into this fight, so I don't think it would have been this close. Maybe it would have been. Maybe I'm just mad because bad. I'm not mad at all. I actually enjoyed this run. This is a really fun run. Nothing bad about it. Let's just pop this now just so we can get up in there. Try to get him out of this phase. All right, he's in his second phase, which our Algiz might run out before he gets back up. Just because this animation takes so long. I mean, it's not quite out yet, but I think it's going out. It's not going out. That's our infamy popping. Yeah, we're going to be fine. It's going out now, but it's a little too late for Mega Satan, I think, to come back from this, even with no Algiz active. Daddy Longlegs putting in the work. Dry Baby putting in the work. Again, Dry Baby putting in the work. The dodge is on point. That's going to be it. That is going to be it. Another Mega Satan kill. Are you guys sick of Mega Satan yet? Let me know in the comments. I don't know if you guys want to continuously see Mega Satan. I don't know what it is, but the runs always provide us either a key, a get out of jail free card, angel rooms, whatever the case may be. It just seems like there's always a chance to fight Mega Satan, and when there's a chance to fight Mega Satan, I feel like I should. If I'm wrong on that, let me know in the comments, because I would be curious to find out if you guys find those fights interesting or even care about Mega Satan. If you just rather see me go fight Blue Baby, let me know in the comments. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode, and if you did, feel free to leave a like. It does help me out. And hope you guys enjoy the rest of your day. Until next time, stay safe, stay up, peace out.